Congratulations, ladies, on the show. I love it. It's the perfect time for a series like this to come out. I guess this question's for the both of you. Both Asta and Darcy are a catalyst to how Harry can become more human. What specific things do each of you bring to the table to help Harry along his journey?
I think that Asta Asta's like a good friend to have when you're going through something, right? She's a good man in a storm. And the storm right now for Harry is his emotions and handling feelings. And, you know, Darcy's the other friend you need, which is the one that helps you have fun and teaches you how to party.
Have very tricky, like, goosebumpy feelings. That's what Darcy helps out with, right?
And also, Sarah.
And also, like, so much fun. Darcy brings the fun, and Asta brings this, like, seriousness, which I think is a good blend for both of them, but I think it helps Harry immediately learn both sides of being human, you know?
Yes, yeah. There seems to be a lot, you guys seem to have a lot of fun, especially like the bar scene in the first episode. Are there a lot of like unscripted things that happen, especially with Alan, that don't make it to the final cut?
Jezzer, wouldn't you like to know?
Of these scenes, because he shows up and I never know what he's going to do next. And it's so organic, so fresh.
Yeah, and there's so much physical stuff that isn't in the script. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a part in the script where, you know, Harry needs to learn how to human. And so what is that entail? And you just see Alan Tudyk, Jerry Lewis, his way through understanding the fingers and understanding the actions of saying syllables. Human, mm-hmm. You know, because his language isn't like that. They don't enunciate words in his language. So that's all Alan. And it's just like you press a button on him and make him go. So
that's true. He knows when to stop either. I mean, he's still just like, after we get, it's like we're cut, and he's still doing things.
Yeah. He doesn't finish when cut. It's like he finishes when he finishes his process.
I think prepared very well, just like letting the camera roll on him, mm-hmm. and seeing what happens.
Now, when you guys were approached with this story for the pilot and everything, from the paper to what was actually filmed and what actually came out, were you surprised on anything, or what really intrigued you about the story?
Yeah, I was very surprised. I had been on another show that was an alien dramedy filmed in Canada. So I was like, well, here we go again. And I think that it being an Amblin property has given it that heart and that soul of like a kind of a throwback. We're gonna see what happens when we take outer space, people from outer space and people from Earth, and see what they have in common. And it really pares down the sci-fi into this, you know, little bit of heart and soul. I'm losing my capacity for speaking, but you know what I mean. So I was really surprised with how grounded it is and how quickly you sink your teeth into who these characters are.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I think that was what I was going to say too. The heart. The heart is really what surprised me the most. Chris Sheridan's writing is such a good blend of comedy and drama, but also very, very meaningful, that it was like, oh, wow, this is more than just a sci-fi. This is more than just even like a murder mystery, a family drama. This is like a human observation. This is like not a period piece, but a piece of this time period that we're living in right now. Yeah. That is what was so intriguing.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, I agree. I think after this quarantine, we're all going to be coming out acting a little like Harry, just getting back into getting those social cues, you know, and getting back into society. Well, thank you so much.
Seeing people's mouths again.
I know. Well, thank you so much for you guys' time, and I can't wait for everybody else to see this. Thank you so
much.
Thank
you. Oh, I'm so excited.